And we are continuing our coverage of the wall that heals in Spartanburg this week. Our Elise Devlin was there today to hear more stories from those who visited.
Days into the wall that heals being open here, more and more people are continuing to come out to hear stories and share their own.
For volunteers like Dean Juergen, places like the wall that heals have turned into purpose.
My place in life is to help those who struggle. And if I can share my story and tell them what I went through, gives them hope that they can get through theirs.
Having served in Vietnam, he's familiar with the struggle of returning to civilian life. For some, he says, those experiences turned into scars.
We neglect oftentimes the ones that carry on from day-to-day life and struggle. And there's some that don't make it. They may be walking around with wounds that you can see, and they may be walking around wounds you will never see. And they need the same help.
And after 10 years of volunteering, Juergen has met countless veterans, some who share their stories and others who would rather not. But what remains true about all of the veterans is the unspoken bond they feel while walking together past every name.
A little bit of relief that I finally got to come honor the guys that deserve all the honor in the world, not just the guys, the ladies too, because there were a lot of ladies who sacrificed.
And it's not rare for memories you forgot about while serving, says Ford, to pop up while taking in each name. And the ones that seem to come up the most are the ones involving the relationships formed while overseas.
I've made several Vietnamese friends because, and we all look at one another and go, why? Why can't we just be friends like we are now?
But no matter what emotion arises for the veterans while touring the wall that heals this week, the one that trumps them all is gratitude.
It means everything. When you look at the cost of freedom, it's not wrote on paper. It's wrote in blood. It's wrote in names like this wall behind me.
In Spartanburg, Elise Devlin, 7 News.